शचीपुत्रमत्रस्वरूपम् रूपम् तस्याग्रज उरिपुरीम् माथुरीम् गोष्ठवाटीम् राधाकुण्डम् गिरिवर्महो राधिका माधवासम् प्राप्तो यस्य प्रथितकृपया श्रीगुरुं तं नतोऽस्मि वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरद्विजे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो भक्त्या विहीनापराधलक्ष्यै क्षिप्त्वाश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्यै कृपामयी त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्देनुमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्देनुमस्ते चरणारविन्दं तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणान्ति Come along me, with me, in Varanasi, Kashi, on the bank of Ganges, on Ashwamedh Ghat, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is sitting there, and Sanatana Goswami and Chandrasekhar and some of associates were there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving teachings to answer to the question of Srila Sanatana Goswami. Who I am? Why I am so suffering? And I am suffering from the birth and death. I'm drowning in the birth, in the ocean of birth and death. Old lands and so many diseases, all things. How I can be happy? Three questions are related to three gyan. Sambandha gyan, अभिधेय ज्ञान एंड प्रयोजन प्रयोजन तत्व संबंध तत्व अभिधेय तत्व एंड प्रयोजन तत्व हु एम आई एम चेतन महाप्रभु इज टेलिंग दैट ओ
पहला अध्याय
सुन लो नाउ एक्सप्लेन मी फर्स्ट नॉट Sanatana Goswami. So I forget that and came to Banaras. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami in Radha Damodar temple. There he is writing. Very solitary place. It is in Seva Kunja. It is a Siddha place. You know Siddha place?
Place of perfection.
Because Krishna has played there. The feet dust of all the gopis, especially Srimati Radhika, is there. Especially Krishna used to come there and to serve Srimati Radhika, so it is Seva Kunj. Best place in Vrindavan. Bansibat and this place. Also there is a place, Nidhuvan. Same thing. So here Krishna is controlled by Prem. Radha is also controlled by Prem. Here Prem becomes personified, like a person controlling Krishna. Srimati Radhika, gopis, all so we want Krishna Prem, not Krishna only. If there is no Prem, no affection and love for Krishna, then we will like Kansa, Jarasandha, Shishupal, like demons. So, he has told first that here he is telling that Krishna is manifested in this world in six ways.
Six features.
Krishna himself, two kinds of guru, bhakta, avatar, prakash and shakti. First is he is explaining guru. Bande guru, mantra guru arjata. I will try to explain it very shortly.
Briefly.
Because I will have to complete 3 and 4 chapters. Most important. But this is background. Without this, we cannot explain all these things. And that is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to this world. Also, our disciplic orders, all acharya has come for this. Mantra guru are jato shikha guru gan. Tahar charana age kariye bandan. Mantra guru are shikha guru jato. Mantra guru means diksha guru. And shikha guru, those who teach us how to serve Krishna. Who are you? What is bhakti? What is jiva tattva? And how a jiva, a soul, conditioned soul, can achieve bhava bhakti and from bhava bhakti to prema bhakti? Bhakti is one prema bhakti, the service of Krishna. And Rupa Goswami has told it that anna abhilashita sunyam jnana karma
navritam.
Then anukullena
bhakti.
Those who want to achieve this bhakti, they should remember this slok first and repeat daily once. And try to go deep in this. And then practice. Well, we will begin practice, then it will be sadhana bhakti. From your senses, your indriyas. And when a mood will come, then it will be bhava bhakti. And when we will have prem, then it will be prema bhakti. It is called sadhana bhakti, bhava bhakti and prema bhakti according to the stages of sadhaks. Understand? Sadhaks only. So, all are same. Those who gives all this, really he is guru. Those who cannot give this thing, sadhana bhakti, bhava bhakti and prema bhakti, and they are not realized about all these things. They may do a guru work, but really they are not guru. Because it is then told in Srimad Bhagavatam and all Upanishad everywhere. इसलिए गुरु के पास में जाओ तस्मात गुरु प्रपद्येत जिज्ञासु श्रेय उत्तमम शब्दे परे च निष्णातम शब्दे निष्णातम परे निष्णातम च ब्रह्मण्युपशमाश्रय वी शुड नो दिस मीनिंग चैतन्य महाप्रभु ऑल्सो सपोर्टेड दिस आइडिया Krishna also, all epics, Srimad Bhagavatam. Go to Guru. If you want to have really happiness, really bhakti to Krishna and realize Krishna. And who am I? How can I progress in this life? Then go to a very realized soul. Or he has some realization about this. And he will help you, surely. The symptom of that guru has been told that sabde cha pare cha. What is the meaning of sabde? He is perfect in Ved, Upanishad, Srimad Bhagavatam, all the books. But only with this will not do, whether he is perfect or not. But he has no realization of Krishna. Not doing so much bhajan, he is not so much progressed and realized in bhakti, then he is not guru. Even he knows all kinds of shastra, arguments and everything. So there are three symptoms of guru. Shabda brahma nishnat. He should know all the arguments of all the shastra. And secondly, he should be detached from worldly desires, material desires. These are two
external symptoms.
And swarup system, swarup
internal.
That is Brahma Nishnatam Pare. Pare who is from? Pare from Brahma. Who is? Krishna himself.
Param Brahma.
Why Param Brahma? You taking this meaning? Oh Bhagyam, Nanda Gopa Prajau Kasham, Janamitram Paramanandam, Purna Brahma Sanatanam. Krishna is Param Brahma, Purna Brahma, Sanatan Brahma. So he should have some realization, otherwise, he will go down. He may fall if he has no relation. He is only knowing some arguments of the shastra from books, but he has not done so much bhajan, and that is why they fell down. Even they know all the arguments, everything, sometimes practicing something, but not detachment of world, material things. And that is why they fell down. So we must go to the persons, devotees, who should not fail. Otherwise it will be very, very problem for us. If Guru falls, then our whole life becomes upset. No? So, we should be very careful to this. So he is telling here, Mantra Guru ar jato siksha guru gan, tahan charana age kare bandhan. What he has written, Swamiji?
I first offer my respectful obeisances at the lotus feet of my initiating spiritual master, and all my instructing spiritual masters.
Yes.
Purport. Srila Jiva Goswami, in his thesis Bhakti Sandarbha, has stated...
Very carefully you should hear. Very important in life.
Has stated that uncontaminated devotional service is the objective of pure Vaishnavas, and that one has to execute such service in the association of other devotees. By associating with devotees of Lord Krishna, one develops a sense of Krishna consciousness and thus becomes inclined towards loving service of the Lord. This is the process of approaching devotional service, approaching the Supreme Lord by gradual appreciation of devotional service. If one desires unalloyed devotional service, one must associate with devotees.
Yes. Mark this line. If you want what?
Unalloyed
devotional service, you must meet
associate with
Vaishnava. And if you are not doing, then what will be the result?
Asatsanga.
Asatsanga. You will be in Asatsanga. So try to follow these lines of Swamiji. Some tells that you are not in a line of Swamiji. But I think I am more in line of Swamiji. I am following all the totally worlds of Swamiji. Perhaps they are not following, and that is why I tell that you are in not line of Swamiji. You should see. And you can judge yourself. Whether I am in line of Swamiji, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Goswami or not, I am not going to tell anything against this. Totally I am giving to the whole world his message. This is message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, our Rupanuga, all Vaishnavas. So we should very strongly and boldly try to follow these things. If we want unalloyed service of Krishna, devotional service, if you want. And if you don't, you want to make money and see that, if I'm going to follow these lines, then my money problem will be. Come. And so I should not associate with good and high class of Vaishnava. And if you want, like Prahlad Maharaj, then you can mix with, associate with what Swamiji is telling. Again this line and go on. If you want...
If one desires unalloyed devotional service, one must associate with devotees of Sri Krishna.
Yes.
For by such association only can a conditioned soul achieve a taste for transcendental love and thus revive his eternal relationship with God in a specific manifestation and in terms of the specific transcendental mellow or ras that one has eternally inherent in him.
If you will do like this, Krishna will manage everything for you. Don't fear. Krishna has given birth. He is controlling everything. So why we should fear for all these things? For these problems. All the problems will be solved by this. And then Krishna will manage everything. So be bold like this. And try to associate qualified Vaishnava. If you want unalloyed service of Krishna.
I need to come.
Because not only time, three times it has been told. Sadhu Sangha. Again, Sadhu Sangha. Again,
Sadhu
Sangha. Sarva Siddhiya. Sarva Siddhiyas. What is the meaning? Unalloyed of service of Krishna can be attained by this. This is our first duty to follow all these things. Go on.
The secret is that one must submissively listen to those who know perfectly the science of God and one must begin the mode of service regulated by the preceptor or teacher.
Yes.
A devotee already attracted by the name, form, qualities, etc. of the Supreme Lord may be directed to his specific manner of devotional service. He need not waste time by approaching the Lord through logic.
Yes. Don't try to achieve Krishna by logic. Logic mere cannot do. If he logic controlled by prema or devotion, and if it is favorable to Shastra, like Bhagavatam or Chaitanya Charitamrita, then that logic can be somewhat taken. Otherwise, don't go towards logic. Go on.
The expert spiritual master knows well how to engage his disciples' energy in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. And thus he engages a devotee in a specific devotional service according to his special tendency.
One thing you should understand it. Then if a bona fide guru is there, all disciples will think that he loves much more me, other than anyone. You know? This is the sign, this is a symptom of a real guru there. All Gurudev, all Vaishnavas, all disciples, all who are not disciples, come in his touch. They will feel in their hearts that he loves much more me than anyone. We have seen this thing in my Gurudev and also Swamiji. I think there are so many devotees of Swamiji. They can realize this. He used to
look after.
प्यार करना चाहता था आपको प्यार करता था. He always
was he loving you?
Loving you. So I think all will realize this fact that my Gurudev loves me much more than anyone. You are disciples of Prabhupada. Oh, you think? He was so much happy about your service. So this is the first thing. We have heard from the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Even a little boy, even a girl, innocent girl, anyone, those who were superior, all used to think that I am so much loving to my Gurudev. He loves much more me. This is the thing. This is the actual symptom. Because he has no worldly gain at all from any his disciples. He wants to give his heart and Krishna into their heart. This is the thing. And if he is not perfect in the realization of Krishna prema, he cannot give these things. He cannot make seat Krishna in your heart. Guruji never takes the heart of disciples for himself to gain it. He takes the hearts of all devotees, makes it so smooth,
so soft, fragrant,
and so sweet, and he offers it to in the lotus feet of
divine couple,
not directly by giving them in his Gurudev lotus feet and to he Param Gurudev, Paratpar Gurudev, and thus it will come in the lotus feet of Rup Manjari, and she will give it to Vilalita Abhishaka, and they will offer in the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika, and Radhika will engage in the yugal service. So this is the symptom of Shiksha Guru and Diksha Guru both. Then, go on.
devotee must have only one.
If a guru is not doing like so, then you can pray him that please allow me that I should associate any good Vaishnava. His Gurudeva will himself tell that I cannot satisfy you. You should go to Jiva Goswami. You should go to Rupa Goswami. You should go to Narottam Thakur.
Keshaji Gaujaman.
He will not envy. Envy means?
Be envious.
Envious. He will not be envious. Oh, why you are going to that person? He will take you. But Jiva Goswami cannot do like this. Serve your Gurudev. Come to me. And be more qualified to serve your Gurudev and Krishna. He wants no worldly gain at all. If he wants worldly gain, then he is not Guru. Truly. He will tell that, like Hridayananda of Kulin Gram to his disciple Shyamananda, that go at once to Vrindavan in Seva Kunj at the lotus feet of Jiva Goswami. He will make you qualified to serve Radha and Krishna. And Jiva Goswami did it. Actually, Jiva Goswami has no shishya, but all world is his disciple. This is the symptom of a real Gurudev. Then?
A devotee must have only one initiating spiritual master, because in the scriptures, acceptance of more than one is always forbidden.
Yes.
There is no limit, however, to the number of instructing spiritual masters one may accept. Generally, a spiritual master who constantly instructs a disciple in spiritual science becomes his initiating spiritual master later on. One should always remember that a person who is reluctant to accept a spiritual master and be initiated is sure to be baffled in his endeavor to go back to Godhead.
What? Again?
One should always remember that a person who is reluctant,
hesitant
to accept a spiritual master and be initiated is sure to be baffled in his endeavor to go back to Godhead.
Yes.
One who is not properly initiated may present himself as a great devotee, but in fact, he is sure to encounter many stumbling blocks on his path of progress towards spiritual realization, with the result that he must continue his term of material existence without relief. Such a helpless person is compared to a ship without a rudder, for such a ship can never reach its destination. It is imperative, therefore, that one accept a spiritual master if he at all desires to gain the favor of the Lord. If there is no chance to serve him directly, a devotee should serve the spiritual master by remembering his instructions. There is no difference between his instructions and he himself. In his absence, therefore, his words of direction should be the pride of the disciple. If one thinks that he is above consulting anyone else, including a spiritual master, he is at once an offender at the lotus feet of the Lord. Such an offender can never go back to Godhead. It is imperative that a serious person accept a bona fide spiritual master in terms of the Shastric injunctions. Srila Jiva Goswami advises that one not accept a spiritual master in terms of hereditary or customary social and ecclesiastical conventions. One should simply try to find a genuinely qualified spiritual master for actual advancement in spiritual understanding.
Very good. He is always following Jiva Goswami.
Yeah.
One thing I want to explain here, that to have a guru like this, having all qualities, is very rare in this world. No? Very rare. But if we have some past impression, we have done some sukritis, and at that time we have, in lower stages we have some guru anyhow, not real guru, but yet some guru, Vaishnava guru, even a Kanishta adhikari, no harm. Then he, in that birth, he has some impressions. So when he will come in this birth, then he will choose a very real guru. And how to choose? We should give up ourselves in the lotus feet of Krishna and pray. Because he is Siksha Guru, inner guru. He will hear.
Chaita Guru.
Chaita Guru. No? Always hear. If you pray that, oh Krishna, I want to serve you, please give a good guru, qualified guru. Then Krishna will listen it and he will manage. And if you are not doing like so and managing yourself, that I will choose my guru, I will
find out.
Pariksha,
exam.
I will examine my guru, then you will fall down. Bhakti is always sarva dharmano parityajyamam ekam sharanam antvam papebhyo mukshyam. If you will surrender without any worldly gain, sincerely, Krishna will surely arrange. So be like that. So everything depends on Krishna. Easily we can have that rare guru in this world. In this world, very rare guru. And more than that, very rare disciples are in this world. It has been told in Shastra. Very rare devotees are, disciples are in this world, who gave himself like Arjun to Krishna. Like Krishna and Sudama gave everything in Sandipani. Like Jiva Goswami gave himself in all respect to the Lord's feet of Rupa Goswami. I think there are so many instances of guru and disciple in Vedas, Upanishad, Purans. But not like Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami, Sanatana Goswami. Who is the guru of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sanatana Goswami and Rupa Goswami? He has written so many books. In all books he has, in Mangalacharanam, he has prayer in the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as his guru. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave initiation to Rupa and Sanatan, where?
Prayer.
First sacrifice was done there? Any mantra he gave to them?
He inspired everything in their heart.
They adopted everything. Like Guru, this is the main thing. To whom we follow, internally, outwardly. And give easily, swabhavik rupse,
naturally,
our heart in this lotus feet. He is actually Guru. Whether he is initiated by that mantra or not, or fire sacrifice has been done or not. These are external things. So in Shastra, Jiva Goswami has told, he has no so much time to write all these things because a Ramayana will come there, or Mahabharata, like Mahabharata so long. So he has not given all the examples. So it has, there are two kinds of disciples. Two kinds of diksha, initiation. Anushthaniki and Vidvat Rudi. Anushthanik means only fire sacrifice has been done and Guru has told, oh, Gopijana Vallabhaya, Swaha, Om Bhur Bhuva, Prachodayat. He has told. And he thinks that, oh, I should give so much donation to Gurudev, representation so much, fair sacrifice to done, my head has been shaved. And I am now Dikshit Vyakti. I have been initiated. This is outwardly, not Vidvat Rudhi Vritti. When it will be Vidvat Rudhi? When we will give our heart in the lotus feet of Gurudev, everything, and Guru, they will make me so qualified to serve Krishna. And Divya Gyan. What is Divya Gyan?
Divine knowledge.
What is divine knowledge? Who is Krishna? Who am I? What is Maya? Illusory Maya. Now we see in here in this country or Western, all Western countries, that there is a very big problem between husband and wife. They have divorced so many times. They are very worried for their children. What to do? What to do? Very big problem. I pray you all that don't make this problem. Like Indian system, if you are married once, you should be married for
whole life.
Whole life. For little problems, you should not divorce each other. Don't be so much attached or don't so much detached. Try to do your kartavya.
Duty.
Duties only. That this is, she is my Krishna's servant, maid servant, I am servant, my boys or children are servant of Krishna. I should serve them. Only this. I should develop their Krishna consciousness. This is my duty. Don't be attached. So Guru gives all kinds of knowledge, Divya Gyan. What is Maya? What is Krishna Tattva, Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva, Prema Tattva? Everything. And how we should practice bhakti? How should we develop our affection, love for, unalloyed service of Krishna? This is Divya Gyan. And Kuryat Papasya Sankshaya. Means?
Destroy sinful.
All sinful actions. What are sinful actions?
Prarabdha.
All kinds of worldly problems. So much attaching in worldly affairs. Having so many requirements, worldly requirements. Having so much lust, so much anger, all these things. Bad activities we have done in past. And that are four kinds. What are four kinds? Prarabdha, aprarabdha, koot and avidya. All these things. Avidya means to forget Krishna. And then everything, problems comes. So Gurudev destroys all these things. If he cannot do, then we should try to have accept any Siksha Guru. more advanced. We should pray Krishna or Gurudev also. That Gurudev, these are my difficulties. So try to solve. If he is bona fide Guru, he will tell, he will give advice that go to Rupa Goswami, go to Narottam Thakur, go to others who are advanced. And if that disciple goes there, to associate. If he envious, then what to do? Then we will think that you should give up him or not. We should think. If he is against Vaishnavas and Krishna, all teachings, then we should give up. But not daily doing. Even in India, even a karmi does not give up his Gurudev for whole life. He thinks that he is God, he is Krishna. So we must treat like this. If your Guru not so much so high qualified, then taking permission, we can associate from higher rank of Guru. He will himself advise you to do. And if he does not do, then I think he deserves no quality of qualified Guru. He is telling now, Mantra Guru or Shiksha Guru. Tell me when it will be 25 minutes.
Already. 42 minutes have been passed.
42?
42 minutes.
It went down in a moment. Yeah. One kirtan should be done to take me rest. And then I will. Anyone? You can you do any kirtan?
She's a professional.
Krishna Das. What kirtan?
Jaya Radha Madhava. Jaya Radha Madhava. Jaya Kunja
Bihari. Jaya Radha.
Srila Krishna Das Goswami, and attentively hear and try to follow. He is telling Sri Rup Sanatan Bhatt Raghunath, Sri Jiv Gopal Bhatt, Das Raghunath, Echhaya Guru Shiksha Guru Jyamar. He is praying first to his Shiksha Guru. Why you can think about this? Also, he has not named his Gurudev. Here he has told about Guru so many things. Shiksha Guru has taken the name of Shiksha Guru. Who? Srila Rupa Goswami first, Sanatana Goswami, Jiv Goswami, Gopal Bhatt Goswami, Raghunath Bhatt Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Shiksha Guru. He has taken directly Shiksha from them. And especially to both, whom? Rupa and Raghunath. Because he will write in the last of each chapter. Why he could not name his Gurudev? Was any Gurudev Dikha Guru or not? I think it is impossible that he has no Dikha Guru. He has Dikha Guru. Some tells that Srila Raghunath Bhatt was his Gurudev. But I have not seen any
evidence
in anywhere. So authentic. If his Guru was what harm to tell? Nothing. I think it may be wrong or right, I cannot say, because anywhere it has not written. I have to conclusion that he and his brother in his life, in his grihastha, ashram, has been initiated by any Guru. No? That is, his name has been kept Krishna Das. Without any diksha, anyone cannot keep name like this, Krishna Das. But as a professional, he was Kaviraj. Kaviraj, Ayurvedic doctor. Very good. He used to know pulse, and also the pulse of the devotees for that disease also. Was so much good doctor. So there he has been initiated, but he left his brothers and everyone. And it seems that he has taken something side of his elder brother, perhaps. It may be not. And that is why he had not taken the name. Or there may be some all other. But I think if he has made Shiksha Guru like Rup, Sanatan, Jiva, Raghunath, six these, ritualized soul, also associates of Krishna and also of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, like Rup Manjari, Sanatan Goswami, Lavanga Manjari, Bhatta Raghunath, Guna Manjari, Jiva Goswami, Vilas Manjari, Gopal Bhatta, Guna Manjari, Raghunath Das, Rati Manjari. And in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pastime, Sri Rup Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Sri Jiva Gopal Bhatta. There are two forms. No doubt they were eternal associates. If anyone is direct Shiksha Guru like this, why he will not be so bona fide disciple? So he is proud of that Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, all are like this. Ta sabara charane mori koti namaskar. Innumerable dandot pranam in their lotus feet. And then he is praying to bhakta. Like Srivas Pandit. Bhavanir bhakta jato Srivasadi pradhan. Srivas is Narad. These are bhakta. Bhakta are of two kinds, realized bhakta and sadhak bhakta. Narad in his first life, he was sadhak bhakta. And after that he became a realized bhakta, premi bhakta. Here also he takes Sarup Damodar, Raya Ramanand, all the bhakts, Sikhi Maiti, Madhavi Devi, Sarvam Bhattacharya, all he takes. But prominent Shiksha Guru, six these, and all taking like Bhakta, because they have really some direct connection with six. Advaitacharya, Prabhu Ansavatar. Ansavatar meaning?
Part incarnation.
Incarnation of Krishna. Mahavishnu. Nityananda, Swarup Prakash, Vaibhav Prakash, like this. Gadadhar Pandit, Jagadananda Pandit, all are Shakti. Yes. Why Gadadhar Pandit was so generous, having no Bhamya Bhav, Form of how you know?
Leftic mood.
Always in serving to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Not in angry mood, that is man, to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Jagadananda has like this. Because Gadadhar Pandit was herself Radhika. And he was always watching and looking after, guarding Krishna, whether he is playing a good role of my part or not. Like a teacher.
Prompter.
So, she is like that, Gadadhar Pandit. Always was. If he, Krishna, tells anything,
then he
at once makes Sudhar. Sudhar means?
Reforms.
Like when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met with Nityananda Prabhu in the house of Nandana Acharya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was weeping and telling this slok. Varaha pidam natavara bapu karanayo karanikaram bibhratabhasa kanak kapisam vajayanti chamala. Pitiful rupa of Krishna. But he could not play the role of Radhika. Something like him. So behind parda,
curtain.
He played a marvelous role of Srimati Radhika, Gadadhar Pandit. Weeping loudly, tear coming, melting everyone. And he uttered this slok in so manner that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who was playing the part of Radhika, became careful and he followed him. And he thought that, oh, I've done here mistake. So Gadadhar Pandit is himself Srimati Radhika. Here playing a role of like a teacher here to teach Krishna his mood, because Krishna has taken his mood. Jagadananda? Like Satyabhama. You know all. He is also Shakti. He is praying to all Gadadhar Pandit.
Krishnadas
Kadirajas. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu, Swayam Bhagavan. He is Swayam Bhagavan. Himself Krishna, Vrijandanandan Shyam Sundar. Tahar Padar Binde Ananta Pranam. Savarane Prabhu Kariya Namaskar Ei Chhaya Jaiche Kariya Vichar. I have told Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami telling that. I have told briefly these six kinds of Krishna. Krishna himself. Like six manifestations. Himself Krishna. Yadyapi Amar Guru Chaitanya Radas. My Guru?
Servant of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
The servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But I know that he is himself Krishna. Shakshat Haritvena. Samastha Shastra. What is the meaning of Haritvena? Can you define? Explain?
Is Guru is Bhagavan.
No. Sakshat Hari. He has not told Sakshat Hari. Haritvena. There is some deep meaning. He possesses the quality of Krishna, but not Krishna. So he is Das Bhagavan. Krishna Das Bhagavan. He has some qualities of Krishna. So merciful. He is the wholesale mercy of Krishna, Gurudev. So this is the quality of Krishna. So he possesses all these things, but not his Vishaya Krishna. No? If anyone thinks that Gurudev is also Krishna, like Vishaya Krishna, he is not right. So we should know that he has the quality of Hari. That is Haritvena Sakshat. Even karmis, Jnani Tapasvi, they also think that Gurudev like Krishna. So we must know this. But we should not do aarop. Aarop means?
Superimposition.
Impose.
To superimpose an idea that's not really true.
Yes. This is mango tree. It will give fruit, mango fruit, and it will be very sweet. This is aarop, not real. If you are seeing any mango tree, and then I am telling that, oh, this is mango, and it will give fruit in time, then it is true.
Real.
But if we suppose unreal to be real, the fruit will be what?
Unreal.
Non-existent.
Not good. So we should know. We should not do aarop. But in beginning we'll have to aarop. No way, other way. So that is called aarop siddha bhakti. But we should aarop in Krishna to be Krishna. Like Krishna, deities are Krishna. We are now seeing, doing like this, but actually deity is himself, Krishna. No? Understand? Deity is himself, Krishna. But we are seeing like a stone, like a statue. We cannot serve it like Krishna. But when our degree of affection will go up and we realize, then we see like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sakshat Brijendananda. Vigranaha tumi.
Sakshat Brijendananda.
Then it will become. Then it will be the real. Guru Krishna Rupam Shastra Pramane. Guru Rupe Krishna Karen, Kripa Karen Bhakta Gane. Shiksha Guru Kadayani Ami Krishna Rasvaru. I will explain it tomorrow. And after that I will take third and forth. Very important, all these things. He will explain who is Guru, who is Shiksha Guru, who is Diksha Guru, what are our duties, to how to serve him. So next day we will explain all these things. Gaur Pramanandi.
Prabhupada has translated this verse, Nityananda Roy Prabhu Swarup Prakash Tana Parapadma Vando Yahamuida. He says, Srila Nityananda Ram is the plenary manifestation of the Lord, and I have been initiated by him. He translates like that.
What? Bring.
It says, Nityananda Roy Prabhu Swarup Prakash Tahara Parapadma Vando Jaramui Das.
Jaramui Das, it means not he has initiated, Das, like servant.
Did I miss heaven? But Srila Prabhupada is initiated and I have been initiated by him.
But he has not clearly written. We are all disciples of Nityananda Prabhu, no harm? No harm. But actually, he has not taken. He can take Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also, Nityananda Prabhu also, like Rupa Goswami Sanatana has told their Guru. He may also consider Nohar. Ekirtan?
In the Gaudiya Math, you have the parampara from right to the left.
There are two things. We always want to keep our Gurudev with us, near. So Gurudev, then Param Gurudev, then Paratpar Gurudev, then Paratmat, and like this. And some things that in right, superior should be there. So they may sit Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj first, then Bhakti Vinod Thakur, then Gaur Kishore Das, then Prabhupada, then our Guru. But I always prefer that my Gurudev should be nearer to me first, and then Param Guru, then Paratpat Guru, then
Is this good?
No
harm. Any questions? The voice is great.
But
Any questions the devotees can
any
address to you?
What is that?
What?
If the devotees can ask questions now.
They can question
tomorrow. Or after the break, they can ask questions.
At tomorrow. Yes. Yeah. Because I cannot speak more than 40 minutes.
Or Guru Dev, we can also do one day questions.
Yes, only question.
One day.
Yes. One day or any day. First yes. You can do question and after that I may begin my classes.
Okay. Okay. Come on.
Come on.
Mahamantra. You should do. Mahamantra. Adhada.
No.
One. Is that enough for one?
I think it's two.
One.
There is more.
Somebody came. There's more coming.